This one's really quite easily. A lot of people that come to you, same as me, in my field now and when I had the salon, they don't know they have a problem. So your idea is to make them see that they have a problem when they come to you. So, for example, we know that when people come to us as hairdressers, they want to look great. We know that. They want to look really good. Otherwise, they wouldn't come. They'll just go somewhere skaggy. But you guys, if you've got a half-decent place, they come because they want to look good. The secret when you put in your adverts or your attention grabbing is what goes here on this question mark. That is what you need to figure out. Everyone puts, look good and come to me. But they don't know they want to look good, even though they do want to look good. Because it's a bit vain to say, I just want to come to you because I want to look good. But they do want to look good. So you've got to figure out what is the flip side, which we can do together now, of looking good. Okay, so looking great, looking good. What's the opposite to that? If we had a coin heads and tails and heads was looking great, what's the opposite from looking great?
Looking shit.
Yeah, yeah. Get to the point, why don't you? Yeah, you know what? I can't really put that in an advert, but that's true. It's
true,
though.
Are you sick of having bad hair days?
Yeah, hey, there's a really good one. Hey, it's the opposite, right, that awakens them to realize they know their pain, but when you say their pain to them, they know you get them. And if you get them, that's what really matters. Now, there's a big change happening at the moment. You're getting me off tangent. You know, we talk about this the three-headed person over here and the sweet spot being in the center. You all know about this one here? We've talked about this before. So this is like telling your stories, what the client's problem is and how you're going to fix it, and then your experience, you know, your salon culture at the bottom. And if you get all three overlap, that's where the money is, and that really is. The people around in 2017, we say we've got to do change, which Marina said. The thing is, most people now, a bit like when I started, they want to go to the best in town only. They want to go to the authority. Who is the best? Now, the problem is we at the moment, we are so lucky, we are in charge of our own media corporation. Like, it's like we can have front page news or front page telly because we have Facebook, Instagram, and we have every way of reaching out to these people from our website and from our emails. We can actually put ourselves as number one in our town really easy. But to be number one, they need to know that you are good. You don't have to be the best. You just have to be the best in their world. Okay? Not in everyone else's world, just theirs. So to be the best in their world, they need to know two things. That one, you can help their problem. And two, you get them. And by understanding this section here, that is when they read it and they go, aha. The amount of times I write or I do a video and someone writes me and goes, you just read my mind, you get me. It's because I know your pain, because I've been there myself. I know what pain you guys are in. And that's why you get that section. We all know you want to look great. But if I said to most people, like Oné, do you want to look great? He'll go, not really. Because he doesn't, but you know, do you want to look shit? Definitely don't want to look shit. You know, it's like that's when they get it. You know, that's the thing, is that bit underneath. So you've got to figure out what you think they want, flip it on its head, and that's what you put in the advert. That flipness, because they really get it.
That's exactly what your marketing's like. For as long as I've known you, that's exactly how you market your thing.
That's only because
you're literally in our mind. It's just everything is just spot on.
Well, it's only because I live your world. The difference is you don't live this corporate person's world. That's why it's harder for you. I live your world. I get your pain. I get the fact that there's nothing worse than you having all these crappy bills to pay and your staff are in the back room laughing and joking like they don't know. That's so annoying to me, but it's real. You know, do you know what's really annoying? You've got the GST bill in, you're just getting ahead, and there's two staff members phoning in sick, and you've got to spend the next 3 days juggling all these bills. It's real life stuff. I get that because I've done it all my life. You know, I've been in the war zone. But if I said to you, there's a lady that comes to you, she's really insecure, she thinks she looks ugly, you think she's hot as, but she really looks ugly, she wants to go for a job promotion, you don't get that. But when you do her hair, you're changing her world. But when you speak about, do you want to look hot and confident, she'll go, no, I don't want to look, I'm an insular person, I don't want to look. But okay, do you want to look like, you know, a rabbit in headlights? you know. Definitely don't want to look like a rabbit stuck in headlights. So it's how you talk of that second bit. She'll go, how does Onne read my mind? And that's when they know that you're the expert and you can fix her problem. And that is the hardest thing, is finding out the flip side. But that's the key to you guys being busy. You build an advert on that flip side, everyone will know that you are the expert because you get them, which means you're the expert in their world. That's what matters, is like your ideal clientele. If you're the expert in their eyes alone, no one else is the expert because no one gets them like you. You can charge what you like. You can do what you like. Pretty hard. It's but that is the thing, is you figure out exactly what you think they want and flip it on its head. Because we all know that one. You know, when we have people coming up, how many times you do hair and they go, I'm going for a job interview tomorrow. I get that all the time. You know, they want their hair done, they want to look great for the job interview. Because really, they don't want to go in there looking like everybody else. They want to look like they're $1 million.